Results were published just in December 2019. Unfortunately, no efficiency was shown in this study. Stocks of the company went down many times. So it was a big confusion for all of us. But we're still waiting for other indications, and the company is carrying on these clinical trials. And other clinical trials of mitochondrial-targeted antioxidants, they relate strictly to SKQ1. These are our clinical studies performed on two pharmaceutical forms of SKQ. First one, eye drops with SKQ, because of some discovery made by people present in this audience, and we thank them very much, Professor Kolosov from Novosibirsk, who discovered that some eye diseases can be treated in animals with SKQ, and we choose our first pharmaceutical form as eye drops. And I will, in the next 10 minutes, go a little bit more in more detail on our clinical trials. This is SKQ. I can save some time. It can be reduced and oxidized in mitochondria, which makes it rechargeable antioxidant, very nice one. It has very nice effect in vitro on inflammation, as Boris Cherniak told us today. It also stimulates regeneration in several systems. For example, this work was done in Mount Sinai Hospital in the United States, and they showed that if you make a wound on monolayer made by human corneal epithelial cells, this wound healing can be very much stimulated by addition of SKQ. Among these results, combined with the results of our laboratories and the results of Novosibirsk group, we finally made our first pharmaceutical form, eye drops. So they called visimetine or visimetine. I even don't know how to pronounce it in English. It's some standard composition for eye drops containing polymer base, preservative, saline, phosphate buffer, and very small amount, 250 nanomolar solution of SKQ1. That's it. We have several versions. We have 10 times stronger visimetine, and 30 times stronger means 30 times higher concentration of SKQ inside. Our first clinical trial was done in Russia, in Moscow. It was open-labeled, randomized study, and we showed that visimetine works better than artificial tear on such a, well, simple but not but quite unpleasant eye disease as dry eye syndrome. Remember this corneal epithelium cells regeneration stimulation that we tried to use this effect of SKQ with this disease. And we observed several things. For example, percent of patients who reported no symptoms after 3 weeks of treatment was statistically higher in the group of visimetine comparing to very good artificial tear. These two solutions, they differ only by addition of SKQ1. It's another study. This time it was double-blind, placebo-controlled. And in all these our studies, placebo is actually not placebo. Some companies, they produce this solution as an artificial tear, as a quite effective drug against dry eye syndrome. And you see that in this study, this artificial tear works very good, but to a certain level. After 4 weeks of treatment, the effect stopped in placebo group, but continued. The effect was healing of corneal damage. And at this point, treatment was stopped. And in SKQ group, we see statistically significant reduction of corneal damage up to almost a month after the treatment. That's another study now made in United States under FDA approval. It was double-blind, placebo-controlled phase 2 study. We observed similar effect on corneal and conjunctival damage. which was, but in this study we used some interesting system, somehow approved in by FDA, so we allowed to use. Our partners, very experienced company and contract research organization in the United States called AURA, they develop a system when they put a patient with dry eye syndrome into the chamber with very dry air and a fan which is blowing this dry air into his or her eyes. And they provoked to keep their eyes open because they're watching TV during about an hour in this chamber. It provokes, fortunately, reversibly, that's why FDA approved this system, provoke a little bit of dry eye, and it helps to, well, somehow even the patients, even the symptoms from patient to patient. And with this system, you can use much lower number of patients, so you risk much lower number of health in your studies. It was used, and we obtained similar results to what we did in Russia and Ukraine study. But one result was really interesting. I will come back to it in a minute. It seemed that after this dry eye challenge, eyes of the patients who underwent SKQ treatment were very much protected from this dry eye. Their eyes reacted in opposite way to this dry eye treatment comparing to placebo control. So all these studies, they allowed us to have Visametin approved in Russia. It is, we set up manufacturing and all the sales and marketing and all these unscientific things, but they're necessary if you want to see your drug in the drugstores and deliver to patients. And I'm happy to say that now we produced and sold more than 2 million vials of Visametin. At this point, I must declare some conflict of interest. At the same, I am a researcher who is working with SKQ and eye drops, but at the same time, I am CEO of the company which is producing these drops. But I will try to stay as far from advertisement as possible. So this result scientifically is very important because we set up, as it's prescribed by law, a pharmacovigilance system in our company. Each bottle of Visametin has a telephone number or other addresses, so patients and doctors, they can report side effects if they observe of SKQ treatment of their eyes to us or directly to Ministry of Health. So in some way, it was kind of 2 million separate experiments done. And the side effects reports are very rare, and they mostly relate to allergic reaction to preservative present in our eye drops. So we are very much satisfied with the safety of this drug. Another nice thing, when you have your drug approved, doctors can prescribe them off-label and to use on other indications. And one of the obvious indications for mitochondrial antioxidant is mitochondrial disease. And the most common of them, of these disease, is Leber syndrome, Leber hereditary optic neuropathy. One of the Moscow eye institutes performed such an initiative study. It was single cohort, so no control. Patients with diagnosed certain mitochondrial mutations, they were prescribed Visametin, and they observed increase in their visual acuity. Don't be confused by this scale. It's logMAR scale, and in the scale, the lower number means better vision. So the vision was statistically significantly increased, and you see p-value is several tens of millions. So it's quite significant. And we managed to compare it to literature data. There is a paper done on the patients with the same mutation. In this paper, patients were treated with idebenone, and only in 18% of patients, vision acuity was improved. which is normal for this mitochondrial disease. In our patients, this number is about 70%. Another paper where two mutations were studied, and again, SKQ produced much better results because it's mitochondrially targeted, contrary to idebenone. We're very much satisfied with these results, and we're now preparing two things, paper about them, and maybe clinical trials. Maybe we could manage to organize them in the United States in double-blind, placebo-controlled way, but it costs some money. And final, the biggest clinical trial completed so far on vizimetine on SKQ eye drops. It's called VISTA-1. It was phase 3 clinical trial, double-blind, placebo-controlled, made on 250 Americans in the United States. Two versions of vizimetine was trialed, normal one and 10 times more concentrated. 8 weeks of treatment followed by this dry eye challenge. And it produced quite nice results. I have a pile of 30 slides on the results of this study. Of course, we measured everything. But the most, the nicest one is improvement in conjunctiva. So the SKQ promoted wound healing in patients' conjunctiva and cornea. It also reduced ocular discomfort, and all these are statistically, especially in high dose. And again, both are statistically significant results. Here's again, we saw this very strange result after dry eye challenge. On this picture, you see the measurement of tear film breakup time. Our tear, it makes a film on the eye, and if you put a light a certain way and take a timer, you can measure how many minutes this tear stays on the eye. But then it breaks, and you fix this time. It's a typical parameter for dry eye studies. Not surprisingly, dry eye challenge decreased this tear breakup time in placebo or vehicle patients. But somehow this 8 weeks of treatment with SKQ increased the tear breakup time in the patient. So somehow their eyes seem to be trained against this dry eye challenge. And again, it's a very statistically significant effect. And again, it's double-blind placebo control. So nobody knew, not patients, neither doctors, where was vizimetine, where was placebo. Final clinical trial we made on the second formulation of SKQ. It's oral formulation. It's some solution for taking in orally, which contains 10,000 times more concentrated SKQ1. It's called plastamitine. Last year we completed phase one clinical trial here in Moscow. 35 young men took several different dosages of SKQ, actually. And the major goal was to prove safety, and none of them reported any adverse effect, which is very nice. But we also had some important result from this trial. We took blood samples from these patients and managed to detect SKQ1 in the blood after oral administration. So in half an hour, 35 minutes, it appears in the blood. I would vote for higher bioavailability of the drug, so we had some problems with this. But still, it opens way for further development. And so we're now improving, actually, this pharmaceutical form and preparing for phase 2.